In the previous video, we started our button click counter application and were able to add a simple message on the screen that popped up when we clicked on that little menu option in the emulator using a mechanism called Toast. So what we're going to do in this video is add a button to our application so we can actually get it to do something when we click that button. But before I continue, we want to talk a little bit now about the concepts of how Android actually works sort of under the hood. Because what actually happens is Android does a lot of work for us. In years gone by, with older programming languages, it was really on you as the programmer to do all the code. For example, to check if something has been typed on the keyboard, to actually check whether the mouse has been moved, you know, to draw something on the screen, all those types of things. It was actually a lot of work and a lot of effort from a programmer to actually get that to work. But these days, Android, with the program code that they provide us to use, does a lot of that work for us. So what it actually does, as one example, it uses a concept called event-driven programming. So what actually happens is Android is actually, when we're running an application, if I just tap back to our emulator again, when we're running this application, even though it appears to be doing nothing, Android is actually sitting there waiting and processing events, and it's ready to send us back information when an event has happened. So for example, when we click on this little menu button here, the settings menu, when we click on that settings, what's happened is Android knew that happened. It actually registered the fact that we clicked that. And when we clicked on settings, it actually sent a message back to our program to say, oh, by the way, this has been clicked. And what actually happened was, if I go back into the code and show you that section of code, click on that, and actually we'll get rid of our screen down the bottom because we don't need that at the moment. So we'll get rid of our Android screen to make a bit of space. Okay, so what's happened was once that menu button was clicked, the settings menu button was clicked, Android automatically sent this information into this part of the code here. So that was executed automatically. So we didn't have to go out and check for that to happen. What happened was Android did something called a callback. So it sent something back to us to say, by the way, I'm just letting you know that the settings menu button option or button got tapped. So what we did, we then actually wrote a little bit of code, this little bit of code in here to actually do something. So this is what you'll find in Android application development mostly, is you're actually filling in the blanks. So you're not writing a lot of the code to check to see, you know, whether something's happened. What you're doing is you're writing code that's reacting to a particular event. So in this case, the event was a menu item got ticked or tapped, I should say. And what we've said was if it happens to be the settings menu option, which is really the only settings on our particular application, then we're actually doing something. We're actually showing something on the screen. So that's an important concept to get your head around with Android development, is it's handling a lot of things behind the scenes for you so that you don't need to do that. So it's actually going to be doing the, you know, a lot of the groundwork for you. And you're just, as I said, you're just filling in the gaps and actually just adding that little bit of extra code to actually tell it what to do when something happens. Okay, so let's go and add something to the form. So to do that, what we need to do is get a little bit of an understanding of how forms are created, but also how it's all linked together. So when we created our new application, you may recall that it came up with a list of names. We had main activity, activity main, menu underscore main. These were all default options that we selected when we created our application, this application using the wizard. So what I want to do now is just show you how they link together. So main activity was the name that's associated with the actual Java code that we're using in this case to display a message on the screen, but also that the same code that Android is calling back and sending information back off to us. So its purpose, main activity, has got several purposes. The first purpose is to actually draw something on the screen. And there's a command here called set content view. And look, you don't need to know a lot about it, but the bottom line is that is the command that actually shows our form on the screen. So it actually shows this on the screen. So that's its purpose, is to show that on the screen. So that line of code, set content view, r.layout.activityMain, that's what that's doing. It's sending off the code to Android and saying, display this on the screen. The Android code actually physically displays it on the screen. And that's the beauty of that, that we're just saying, display it, and it goes away and does it. Now, likewise, for this option here, menu underscore main, what that means here, this line here, what we're saying is add something to the menu. So the menu is where I click those three little dots and the settings option came up. That's where it's being added. And this is automatically part of this functionality that gets added for us. And you saw this little option here, this action underscore settings. I'm going to explain in future videos how these all interrelate. But at a high level, what I want you to sort of start understanding is that this is all linked together. So when you see these things like set content view and get menu inflator, this is setting up a menu and also setting up the actual screen layout itself. Now, if you take a careful look at these names, you'll notice activity underscore main equates to this name over here, activity underscore main.xml. Likewise, menu underscore main, if I open up the little menu option, there's the menu underscore main.xml. So where you see r.layout.activity underscore main, that is actually looking in this folder here called res, a subfolder called layout, and a file name called activity underscore main.xml. So that's what that's pointing to. So the layout is actually pointing to the actual layout folder. Activity underscore name underscore main is the name minus the XML. And the same principles here as menu. The actual menu is the name of the folder and the name of the file menu underscore main. So that's how you'll see them. But the next thing is that let's go into those files to see what they actually mean. So to look at one, we can just double click. We'll start with layout. Now if I double click that, you'll notice what's happened is because it's a layout and it's in the layout folder, Android Studio knows that this layout is relating to a layout of our application. And that's really what a layout is. It's actually, it's like a form. It's what you see on the screen. So by clicking on that, we were able to see a graphical representation of what this application is going to look like in the Android Studio while we're actually developing our application. And of course, if we go and have a look at actually how it does look, this is it actually running in the emulator and how it would look exactly running on an Android device, you can see it's more or less the same, pretty similar. A few things are different here, the time and so forth, and that's because this is just a graphical representation. So when you're developing Android applications and coming up with layouts and how your forms are going to look like, Android Studio does a good job of showing you the basics, but it will never be 100%. And this is called the preview view, if you like, the design view or the preview view of your layout. It's meant to give you a representation. It's not meant to be really accurate. So you might find it perhaps does it correct 80% of the time or 90% of the time, but to really see what your application is going to look like, you need to go into the emulator. But anyway, this is the graphical representation of our layout file, our layout, which is our, of course, our form. Now down here, down the bottom, you can see we've got two tabs. We've got design and text. So if I click on text, we can actually see there's some code there. And this code relates exactly to that layout. Because the thing is, there's two screens here. And this is the actual code, this code you can see here on the screen. And what I'll do is I'll just close this preview briefly so we can see what we're doing here a bit better. This is the actual code, and I'll just make a bit of space here so we can see it a bit better. This is the code from a programming point of view that is telling Android to actually display what we see on the screen there. And you can probably see a couple of things there. You can see there's hello world text, and you can see this dot main activity. And if you recall, main activity was a file that we saw over here before. That was the Java code. So this is the code that relates to that graphical view that you saw before. And what you can do is you can choose to access it either in here. So the code, the changes you make here are reflected in the graphical view you see, and but also vice versa. Where we make a change to the graphical user, the graphical side, it'll be changed in here as well. So what we're going to do is I'm going to just get rid of those extra spaces that I added. And what I'll do is expand that out. Now, if I'm going to go back and click on down here to design again, I want to show you what actually happens. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to add a button below where it's got Hello World. So to add a button, you should see a list of the various options here, and there's heaps of things there. There's lots of different layouts, and you'll find out about those later. But there's also a lot of widgets here. There's text fields, and all of these are different types of things that will actually be part of an Android application. For example, buttons, checkboxes, progress bars. There's a plain text field for entering data, so on and so forth. So to actually add one, I'm just going to click on button. I'm actually going to drag it over, and I'm holding down my left mouse button. And as I'm holding it down, notice the green arrows and so forth that are showing on the screen there. And notice when I move it over to the left, it's actually showing the green line on the left-hand side border. And likewise, if I moved it up, it's showing the various other options. And what that's doing is it's trying to help you, let you know where it's going to line things up. So I can just move it to the area that I want and then release the mouse button. And we've now got a new button on the screen, as you can see. So once I've done that, if we go back and actually go back and have a look now at our text mode again, I click on text, and notice what it's done. This code here was actually added automatically. So again, if we go back to our design view, there's the button. And by doing that, what's happened is Android Studio has added this code, and all this code will make sense, and we'll talk about what it means in future videos. But the bottom line is I want to let you know that the changes you make here are reflected in the graphical user layout when you're designing a form, but likewise in here as well. So what I could do is I could actually copy that, then I could actually delete that out, go back to design, and notice how the button disappeared. And I could also go back and undo that like so. And I go back to design again and the button appears again. So it's important to understand that this mode, irrespective of which one you use, whether you're using the design or the text, that they do actually relate to each other. Okay, so next, expand this out a little bit more so we can see some of these. All of these things here are particular properties that are part and parcel of this layout. Now, for example, as you click on some of these things, notice how this is changing on the right-hand side. So the text view, I can click on that, I can click on the button. But notice also when I'm doing that, some of these options here are changing because the options as I select them are applicable for whatever I've clicked. So I could click the layout itself and notice up here what I'm selecting is actually shown as selected. So relative layout means I've clicked on the whole form, but I can also click on an individual view and it will actually show the properties that are appropriate for that that you can change. And just to be clear in terms of getting the right terminology, Android call all these things that we put on a form a view. So the basic name, if you will, for this is a view. So when you see a button, that's a view. A text label, that's a view. All these other things all along here are all views as well. So if you see that word view and wondering what that means, that basically is just an element that forms part of a form or a layout. And we'll be going into the specific details more about this a little bit later. So looking at some of these options, I'm going to click on new button. And as I scroll down, there's heaps of these options. You've got all sorts of options and you'll learn some of these as we go through the course. But you've got an important one called ID. And we'll be seeing that in the next video. We'll be actually linking that together and you'll see how the interrelationship between the actual what you see on the screen here and the code back in main activity. But that's the ID. But there's also another one and that's the actual text. So this is the text that you want displayed on the screen in that place for that button. So we could easily just change that and just put my button. And notice when we change that, that gets changed automatically. So what I'm going to do is just run that just to confirm that our button is working. And then the next video, we'll actually start introducing a bit more functionality. So to actually run it, we can just go up to our menu, click on Run Main Activity. You can see that's processing. It's asking where we want to run it. We want to run it on our emulator. You've seen this before. And we'll tab over while we're waiting. And you can see we've got our button. And of course, at the moment, the button does work. There's a button press there, but nothing's happening. And that's the same for the same reason that with this button here, before we added the toast message, when we clicked that, nothing happened. The same deal here. Android is saying, okay, I've noticed that someone's clicked a button, but we aren't taking advantage of that. We haven't added any code to tell the program what to do when that button's clicked. So we'll start looking at that and how to actually get the button to do something in the next video.